Josh, let's talk a little bit about this week at the Cotton Bowl. You guys, are you a senior?
I am a senior.
So you've been around national championship games, different BCS bowls.
Yeah.
Talk to us about how the Cotton Bowl and everything you guys are doing down here kind of compares to those other bowls.
Well, obviously, national championship, you know, is something incredible to experience, especially being in New Orleans and playing for LSU. But you know, last year it was, you know, a little bit of a rocky field to play on. But you know, Orlando is a great city. And then Atlanta for the Chick-fil-A Bowl was a lot of fun too. Played a good team, and looking forward to the Cotton Bowl. Since I've been here, it's been a lot of fun. We've been to a couple of cool places. That stadium is incredible. You know, we got to check that out and got to practice in it yesterday. So it's a lot of fun. We've been treated really well so far.
Now, are you and the punters trying to see if you can bounce it off the score?
Me and my friend Derek, the other punter, we've been trying to hit it a couple of times in practice, and they actually got on the. They got on the intercom and told us not to hit it because it was pretty expensive, apparently. I don't know where they got that idea from. But so we stopped. But I never came close. He came pretty close a couple times. And I think it actually went up into it and then came back out before, but it didn't touch it. So,
talk a little bit about Texas A&M. You know, obviously, place kickers and punters, they prepare a little bit differently. But when you guys are sitting down and you're watching film, you're looking at Texas A&M, tell us some of the things that the coaches are talking to you all about.
Well, they got a great kicker and a great punter, and they also have a great return game. So we're always looking for things like that. You know, our coach, Joe Robinson, he's always, you know, coming and talking to us about ways we can help our special teams be better for, you know, for our opponent. And luckily we get to play against a quality opponent. You know, it's no fun when you get to play against somebody that, you know, isn't up to par in special teams. And Texas A&M is not the case for them. They're very good in what they do, and they take a lot of pride in what they do as well we do. So. The respect that we have for them in the return game and in the kicking game is very, very high. And, you know, I'm pretty sure they respect us. So it should be a really good battle for the special teams this game.
Last question. You've kicked a lot of great game-winning field goals, different things like that. What would it be like senior year in what your coach perceives as the greatest stadium on the planet?
Oh.
Tell us what those feelings would be if you're like sitting there and you're looking, minutes running down, and you're going, oh, wow, I'm going to be the one that gets to go out here and do this.
Actually, to be quite honest, I probably wouldn't be thinking about anything. That's just the way my mind works when it comes down to situations like that. But, you know, after it's said and done, once it sets in, that'd probably be one of the best feelings of my life. Being able to kick in front of that kind of crowd in that kind of stadium against Texas A&M in the Cotton Bowl for my last game as a Tiger, that would be unbelievable. I couldn't ask for much more than that, and it'd be great.